Bueno, muchísimas gracias. Continuamos acá en México. Esta es la conferencia del verano anual de la Asociación de Condados del Estado de Maryland. Todas las jurisdicciones, todos los condados están aquí presentes con sus funcionarios y nosotros tenemos acá al presidente del Consejo del Condado de Montgomery, Andrew Fritzson. ¿Cómo está? Bienvenido. How are you?
I'm doing great, thank you. How are you?
Fantastic. Enjoying this. This is always a lot of fun, a lot of activity, a lot of information, a lot of people. Más de 3,000 personas acá, pero de todas maneras sigue siendo un lugar súper interesante. All right, so any sessions, anything special? Who you been talking to? What's going on with you here? How are you moving around? First time as council president. You've come here, what, 15 times before?
Yeah, 15 times. And it is always a great opportunity to bring people together, particularly mm-hmm. from counties around the state, but also state partners, our legislators, outside partners. It really is a gathering of so many people who are involved in so much that happens on a day-to-day basis in communities across the state.
Es una grandiosa oportunidad. Primera vez que él viene acá como presidente del consejo, pero ha venido aquí 15 veces, 15 años consecutivos, así que es veterano de esta conferencia. Y es como una unión de todos los líderes de las jurisdicciones, del estado sobre todo, y cómo involucrarse cada cual dentro de las comunidades pertinentes para, obviamente, mejorar la calidad de vida de todos nosotros. So, anything new that you... I mean, you've been coming here for 15 years. It comes to a point that it's the same thing over and over again. Budget, transportation, affordable housing. You know, the same issues all the time. Anything new this year? I know artificial intelligence, but anything new that you've heard this year that you've gone,
Yeah, certainly the only thing that is new is different. I used to be the artificial intelligence 15 years ago, and now that's an actual session. But what is really always the benefit to me most of all of coming to this conference is meeting with stakeholders and elected officials, appointed officials, state officials, colleagues and counterparts from across the state. The sessions are great. You learn a lot in those sessions. But really, the tremendous value is hearing from the transportation secretary this morning at the large county breakfast that myself and fellow Montgomery County and other large county representatives went to talk about what's happening in transportation. I spent a great deal of time yesterday evening with the housing secretary, Jake Day, who I've known for many years, talking about what we're going to do to move the ball forward housing.
Before we get into affordable housing, which is a very important issue in Montgomery County, and of course for many of our members of our audience, let me go ahead and interpret that. El tema de la conferencia principal este año en realidad es la inteligencia artificial, pero según nos dice acá el presidente del consejo, Fritzson, pues lo mejor de esta conferencia es pues, el intercambio de voces, de ideas, el estar conversando. Las sesiones son maravillosas y todo, pero es el poder estar en esas conversaciones uno a uno con legisladores, con funcionarios electos y con empleados de todas las jurisdicciones a través del estado. Por ejemplo, el tema del transporte en el día de hoy, mencionaba que hubo una sesión muy interesante con el secretario del transporte, Paul Wetterfeld, en la cual se pudo trabajar precisamente para los temas del transporte. También se ha reunido con el secretario de vivienda del estado de Maryland, con Jake Day. And Jake Day, now keep talking.
Yeah, Jake Day, I've known for many years. He was an innovative mayor at the municipal level in Salisbury, not too far from where we are here on the Eastern Shore. And so he understands what we deal with on a day-to-day basis at the local level. We're really at the forefront of housing. And as chair of the Planning, Housing, and Parks Committee, as someone who has really dedicated most of my tenure to addressing housing issues, it's really great to be able to partner with him. And I think that the state is poised to support the county that is really beginning once again to lead in housing in a way that we used to in the 1970s and 1980s, that we weren't really in the 1990s and 2000. And that we're trying to lead again by being innovative, by being creative, by thinking about how we can support more people to be able to afford to live in more places in our county.
Esta reunión con el secretario de vivienda lo que trae que es una persona innovadora que fue funcionario pues acá en Salisbury, una de las jurisdicciones en la parte este del estado de Maryland, pues es que entiende los retos que hay a nivel local con el tema de la vivienda asequible, y el asociarse y buscar apoyo con él pues va a ayudar al condado de Montgomery a estar en el liderazgo en términos de vivienda asequible. Lo fuimos en los años 70, en la década de los 80, pero en la de los 90, la de los 2000 quizás no tanto, y es hora de que el condado de Montgomery regrese. You mentioned resources. Any promises?
No promises, and in fact, it's the opposite.
Nada. Nada de recursos de promesa.
We're concerned at the county level that the state's fiscal challenges that they are starting to face when it comes to transportation and education and overall budget challenges, that they are going to ask the counties to solve those issues essentially on the backs of our taxpayers and our residents. And we want to make sure that we're working in collaboration with our state partners and making sure that the challenges that we face, that we address them together, because the fiscal issues that we face are shared issues, and the solutions have to be shared solutions.
Exactamente. El reto fiscal que enfrenta el estado de Maryland, pues sobre todo en términos de educación y transporte, va a tener un peso en las jurisdicciones locales. Entonces, un peso que quizás los residentes nuestros sean los que tengan que afrontar esas necesidades, porque los fondos no necesariamente van a venir del estado, así que le toca a las jurisdicciones locales. Es un peso que obviamente quisieran compartir las soluciones en conjunto con el estado de Maryland, porque para resolver habrá que unirse. Affordable housing, you mentioned something really interesting right now, that the Montgomery County was a leader back in the 70s and the 80s, and then not so much, you know, since then. What do you think it's something that the county can do, implement, might figure out resources in order to affront affordable housing in the county?
Well, actually, I think we have been doing this. And yeah. In fact, we, in the 1970s and 1980s, we were considered to be a national model and a national leader. We created things like the MPDU program, the moderately priced dwelling unit program. We created the concept of inclusionary zoning, the idea that when you build new housing developments, that you include housing that's income restricted, that ensures that firefighters and teachers and police officers can live amongst and within the community, and that we set aside units for that. Then in the 90s and the 2000s, we really didn't do a whole lot. We weren't building a whole lot, and we weren't doing a whole lot of innovating when it came to housing. But in recent years, we have been doing that. We created a $100 million housing production fund, which has been featured in the New York Times and on Vox Media, and was highlighted by the White House as one of the best approaches of any local or state government anywhere in America dealing with housing. We just created a $50 million nonprofit preservation fund, which helps our nonprofit partners to be able to preserve existing naturally occurring affordable housing to make sure that it stays affordable for residents.
And I'm going to interpret this. Los 70 y los 80, pues el condado de Montgomery era un modelo nacional en cuanto a la innovación en vivienda asequible. Ahí fue donde se crearon las unidades con precios moderados, las zonas de inclusión, que era para que maestros, policías, que trabajan en nuestra comunidad, pudieran vivir en nuestra comunidad y tener acceso a las compras. En los años 90 y en los años 2000, no tanto, pero ya el condado va en avance. Se ha creado un fondo de $100 millones, que es el fondo de vivienda asequible de $100 millones, y también un fondo de $50 millones para la preservación a través de entidades sin fines de lucro. When you say all this in simple language, to somebody that just graduated, got a really nice job, right? And I'm going to tell you this, I'm going to share this because this is my son, right?
Sure.
Okay, graduated, a product of MCPS, University of Maryland, got a nice job, you know, already making close to six figures. Wants to stay in Montgomery County. It's tough to buy a property in Montgomery County. He did, though. But
good for him. Well, that's impressive.
In Gaithersburg. He did. But, you know, Affordable housing, we understand it has to be for people, the income, lower income. But how are we attending to individuals that I just described that are a product of our community and that might want to stay in our community? By the way, I have a house down the street with five young professionals living together, the rent of the property, because they wanted to stay in Montgomery County. And two teachers, Montgomery County Public Schools, one nurse, Montgomery Hospital, Montgomery County, one protective services officer, and the other one sells software. Five professionals, a product of NCPS, living in Montgomery County. They want to stay in Montgomery County. They can't buy. The five of them are renting together. How do we fix that?
We need more housing.
Yes.
This is the solution to the problem. We cannot solve the housing challenges that we face unless we have a lot more housing than we currently have. Mm-hmm. The root of the issue is there is far too little supply mm-hmm. with far too much demand. Now, we can do a lot after we do that. Mm-hmm. And in addition to doing that, to subsidize the units that we have to make them more deeply affordable to more people. But at the root of it, there is just not enough
inventory.
And that is what is absolutely crushing young people. Mm-hmm. And it's hurting older residents as well, because there is nowhere to downsize to. One of the challenges that we face in Montgomery County, we're actually overhoused in the sense that those who are in a home are oftentimes in a home that is far larger than they need. It has more bedrooms than they need. It has probably more square footage than they need. But there's nowhere else for them to move that is
to downsize.
Makes sense to them, because it actually costs more of what their monthly costs would be to move. And so, you know, downsizing to
that's
most people
me.
Isn't
that's,
just size,
that's his old
it's
lady
cost.
Now.
Yeah, it's cost. And by the way, the challenges facing your son, this is my real life each and every day as well. I live in an area in a two bedroom unit that anywhere I can walk to, anywhere within the general vicinity of where I live, I couldn't come close to affording to be able to live in a four bedroom or, you know, a more family type of
that
unit.
Has those amenities.
Yeah. And so that's that's a tough reality that I live each and every day. And frankly, it's what animates me on the county council. It's why I ran for the county council, because I think it is at the root of so many of the challenges that we face.
Bueno, como pueden ver, la conversación esta de vivienda asequible pues se puso bien apasionada. I love the passion that went on right here, right now. El tema, en realidad, es vivienda asequible. Le preguntaba, ¿no? La gente joven, que es producto de nuestro sistema de que se cría en nuestra comunidad, en el condado de Montgomery, quizás se quiere quedar, quiere comprar una casa, pues no solamente las personas de bajos ingresos que no tienen vivienda asequible, sino también esa otra generación, esa another generation, esa otra generación también está teniendo los mismos retos, que no pueden comprar porque es demasiado caro, que se gradúen con un título universitario. Lo cierto es que no hay suficiente inventario en el condado de Montgomery. Hay zonas con casas, por ejemplo, grandes, donde viven personas ya mayores, adultos mayores, y que son personas que quizás quisieran moverse a una propiedad más pequeña, pero sin embargo le saldría más caro. Y entonces no abandonan sus casas grandes. Lo mismo con alguien que vive en un apartamento, como él, que vive en un apartamento de dos dormitorios, en una zona transitable, caminable, accesible, amenidades que le gustan, y no entonces irse a un lugar con una casa de un cuarto más grande, más aislado, pues también presenta dificultades. Es una de las razones principales por la cual él se ingresó, se postuló al Consejo del Condado de Montgomery. We can talk on this issue forever and a day. I know you have a lot of information on this, but we got to wrap it up. Are you going to go to the beach at all?
After the conference, I hope to at least see the beach for a few minutes.
Después de la conferencia, espera por lo menos por unos minutitos poder ver a la playa. Una vez más, les sigo contando a ustedes que estamos acá en Ocean City, pero lo que menos se hace es ver el mar. Es un poco triste, pero acá la pasamos bien también. Anything you'd like to that we have might have forgotten that you might want to talk about and share with the viewers?
I think you covered it really well. I think the moral to the story here, housing in particular, that we talked a lot about today, We have focused on it as a moral issue for a long time. It's also an economic issue. Mm-hmm. And there's so many businesses that tell us that one of the reasons why they can't hire people or that they wonder whether or not they want to expand or move into Montgomery County is related to whether or not their employees would be able to afford to live mm-hmm. in Montgomery County. It is part of the economic bones of a county, and we need to make sure that we're treating it that way.
El tema de vivienda asequible, pues es uno de esos temas que es moral y también económico. Hay que, muchas de las empresas que quizás están buscando establecerse en el condado de Montgomery o expandir en el condado de Montgomery, uno de los retos que enfrentan es que la vivienda, no hay vivienda para los empleados que puedan traer. Así que es algo que hay que abordar y hay que afrontar. This year's theme is Winter Wonderland. Here in the conference. There, shake the globe. For good luck for affordable housing. Affordable housing.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Unfortunately, too many people, because they can't find a good place to live that they can afford, they're left with luck. And we need to give them better fortune than just being having to resort to luck.
Exactamente. El tema de vivienda asequible no es algo de la suerte, ¿verdad? Es algo que tenemos que abordar para poder ofrecer. Muchísimas gracias, concejal, presidente. Thank you for being here. I hope you can go to the beach for a little bit at least.
Muchas gracias. Thank you, my friend. Appreciate you having me.
E igualmente. Gracias por venir. Nos vemos.